Yo, gentlemen's game here. Bit of a break today from the usual program, but don't worry, next week we'll be getting right back on track with the fourth episode of the Art of Seduction series. So unless you've been living under a rock recently, you might be noticing that everyday life has been rocked upside down. So I hope you guys have been taking care of both your physical and mental health. Most of us have been personally affected by this crisis in some way, shape, or form. Maybe you know someone sick or financially strained, though I hope that isn't the case. Some of you guys know that I was laid off a month ago. Now I want to start off with one message first, loud and clear. This will end. It might not seem like it, but it will end. Plagues have been a part of history since forever, and will probably continue to be so. It might take a few weeks or a few months, but eventually things will go back to normal. Despite what you see in the mainstream media, and despite everything your Facebook friends are saying about doom and gloom and, oh crap, life will never be the same again, blah blah blah. Humanity has been through much worse. I'll be honest, this ain't shit compared to the 1918 Spanish flu. Our great-grandparents went through so much worse, so if they can survive that, then we can make it through this. Always remember to keep your problems in this perspective. What's really important, however, is how you choose to spend the next few months. You see, you pretty much have two options. To stay idle and letting yourself go and allowing whatever skills you have to slip. And the sad reality is that some of you watching are gonna end up choosing the unproductive route, staying at home playing video games and eating horrible food. Or you can stay productive, working on yourself every day so that by the time this whole pandemic situation does blow over, you'll have a massive head start compared to all the other guys who didn't take the opportunity to do the same. So first things first, make sure you're keeping yourself healthy. I know gyms are closed, but there's no reason you can't find some sort of P90X type home workout to stay in shape. You don't want to be that guy who gains 30 pounds in quarantine and scares all the girls away. So eat less if you're not exercising much and just eat healthier. Also, if you're talking to any girl, continue texting them. It's obviously going to be harder right now to meet up for a date or go out to a club, but you can still practice other facets of your game like texting. By the way, check out my How to Text a Girl series right here. If you've been out on a few dates with this girl already though, I'd even suggest calling her, or better yet, FaceTiming her. This is way more personable and easy to get her to invest, rather than just reading words over a screen. Obviously not as good as being able to interact with someone in person, but still enough to keep your verbal skills sharp. In fact, make sure to stay social, period, during this time. Call up your friends or get in a group chat with them. One of the things that I predict a lot of people are gonna have to deal with during this time is mental health, especially regarding social isolation. There's data to already suggest that our generation is among the most socially isolated of all time, and with the social distancing phenomena now taking effect, I worry this is only gonna make things worse. So make sure to get some daily social interaction, whether virtual or on the phone, to keep your emotional well-being intact. Now, the next point I want to make is a more positive one, which is that you probably now have an asset that most people never get enough of, time. Time is probably the most valuable asset that we have. It's the one resource that you can never get back once it's gone. You can always lose money and get it back. You can always get into another relationship after one ends, but we can never get back time. And we spend so much of our time on things that don't yield us anything in return, like commuting on a bus or running errands, just getting caught up in the day-to-day minutiae of life. But now, with over a third of the world population on some form of lockdown, you're probably stuck at home right now with nothing to do and an abundance of time. So this is actually a super rare opportunity that we'll probably never get again to really hamper down on our goals. What I suggest right now is to mentally jot down three goals you want to accomplish by the time your quarantine ends. Like if you've ever wanted to learn to produce music, you should set a goal to download your first program and make your first sample song, no matter how bad it is, before this pandemic ends. If you've ever wanted to learn Spanish, you should set a goal of memorizing like 100 useful phrases in Spanish. If you've been thinking that you might not want to work in the traditional 9-to-5 white-collar job after college, maybe try starting an online business. Point is, you have the world at your fingertips, and the internet as history's greatest resource to learn anything and to help you achieve whatever it is you want to achieve. I also suggest to read a lot during this time. I don't mean news though, I think staying on top of big events is important for sure, but for the most part it's just fear-mongering. Instead, try getting into some self-help. When I was about 22 years old, I went into this 4-year period where I read lots and lots of self-improvement books, and it really played a huge role in my journey into becoming a better man. I suggest books like Failing Forward, The Power of Habit, Awaken the Giant Within, Influence, and Mastery. And finally, dealing with your stress. Look, I'm not gonna pretend that everything's gonna be all sunshine and rainbows from here on out. There's definitely a lot of uncertainty going forward. And people are gonna be stressed because of the physical isolation and being cooped up at home, all bored and getting very little sunshine. That's why I try to meditate every morning and get some calmness and clarity in my mind before it starts jumping all over the place. I'll just start with 5 to 10 minutes every morning, then I'll close my eyes and just try to think about nothing, to just be as present as possible and to just clear my thoughts. I find that it helps me so much, not only just for calming myself down and for my emotional health, but even just being more productive overall, like I have a clearer head. Alright, I think I've rambled on enough. I just wanted to give you a quick update on everything. Remember guys, this is gonna end soon, and we'll be able to go out and socialize with friends and girls. And once we do, we'll appreciate it that much more. So that's it for the video. Do me a favor and like, comment, and hit the notification bell so you know whenever I post a new video. And next week, as I mentioned, we'll be back with The Art of Seduction, so make sure to like and subscribe, and as always, peace.